Hey everyone, so if you couldn't tell by the title, this video is going to be a little bit different, and I considered doing it on my second channel, which is more of a vlog type channel, you know, advice, this and that. But I do have 13,000 subscribers on here versus 3,000 on there, and I really did just want to reach out to more people, but this is like more of a religious type video. And I've been toying with doing a video like this for a long time. The thing is, I do not want to offend anybody in any way. This video is going to be kind of a book review, but it is a religious book. And it's something, I'll get into it in a minute, but it's just really something that I wanted to share with you guys. And maybe if you guys are having trouble, just like reach out to you. If this is going to offend you, please don't watch it. Please don't leave negative comments. But if you're not sure about your religion, if you want to learn more, or if you're already strong in your religion, I would like to share this video with you. So that being said, I hope you guys enjoy. So today, I was not feeling good at all. I had a migraine this morning. I went to school and came right back home because I was just not feeling well. And so my grandpa and his friend just got back from North Carolina, I believe. Yeah, North Carolina. And they were visiting one of my grandpa's friends who he's known for a very long time, who's had cancer, and he's not doing so well. And he gave my grandpa this book, which I'm about to show you. And my grandpa's friend, you know, was talking to him, saying how he's not afraid to die and stuff, and this book really interested me. So today I read this book in about 2 hours. I just laid in my bed and did nothing but read, and I just finished it probably like half an hour ago, and I really wanted to share it with you guys. So the book is called Heaven Is For Real, and it's this story of this 4-year-old boy. He wasn't even 4 at the time it happened. I'll give you a little summary about it in a second, but I don't want to give away too much. But it was really touching, and just the title itself really just kind of captured my attention, because I know a lot of you may not have a religion, because maybe, you know, it is hard to have faith in something you cannot see, and, you know, I understand that, but this book totally puts things in new perspective. So this little boy, Colton, was 3, he was almost 4 when this happened to him. He was sick, throwing up non-stop, and I'm not going to tell you what he had, because I don't want to ruin this for you, but, he had to get surgery, and so basically, after his surgery, like, until months after, he would tell his parents how he went to heaven. And it explains it a lot more in depth, because he didn't really die, but he visited heaven. And this is a true story, and it gives evidence to make you believe that he really saw these things. These things really did happen to him. I'm going to give you an example. I'm not going to ruin this for you, but I'm going to share one of the things that was most touching to me. And his father is telling this story, and in the beginning, it gives you a little background information, kind of. It goes back and forth. You'll see if you read it. But it goes back and forth, and it tells you that Colton is like their miracle son, because his wife had a miscarriage before him, and they never told their almost 4-year-old son that she had a miscarriage. That's not really something you would tell a 4-year-old, and they say that in here. They never told him. So, you know, you get a lot more background when you actually read it, but I'll just read this for you. So this is just the beginning of a random conversation. Their son comes downstairs and says, "Mommy, I have 2 sisters," Colton said. "I put down my pen. Sonia didn't. She kept on working." Colton repeated himself. "Mommy, I have 2 sisters." Sonia looked up from her paperwork and shook her head slightly. "No, you have your sister Cassie, and do you mean your cousin Tracy?" "No," Colton clipped off the word adamantly. "I have 2 sisters. You had a baby die in your tummy, didn't you?" At that moment, time stopped, in the Burpo household, and Sonia's eyes grew wide. Just a few seconds before, Colton had been trying unsuccessfully to get his mom to listen to him. Now, even from the kitchen table, I could see that he had her undivided attention. "Who told you I had a baby die in my tummy?" Sonia said, her tone serious. "She did, Mommy. She said she died in her tummy." And then it goes on, and later he talks more about her, saying... But it has a lot more stuff like that. It goes a lot more in depth, but obviously I don't want to give it away to you. It's a really quick read. It's like 160 pages roundabout, but it's incredible. And another little story, because I'm going to share a video with you guys that I'm going to link down below. So after, you know, his parents know that he visited heaven, they would see pictures of Jesus and ask, is this what Jesus looked like? Is this what, because he described Jesus to them. And then they, anytime they would see a picture of Jesus, they would ask if this is what Jesus looked like. And he would say, no, no, no. So one day, his dad, which is just telling the story, got an email or something from someone showing a CNN report of this other little girl who had like the same situation, has seen like visions from God, or it was something like that, and she did paintings of what she saw. And so the guy, Colton's dad, was watching the video on his computer, and there's a picture she painted of Jesus, and her pictures are gorgeous, and she's like 12 years old. And I'll show you the exact video that they're talking about down below. I'll link it. And she painted a picture of Jesus as she saw him. And so the dad called Colton to look at it, and he just didn't say anything because that was exactly how he saw him as well. So I'll link that video down below. I thought this book was incredibly good. I hope this didn't offend any of you. And if you're still watching it, then you could have closed it out. I'm sorry, but I think this is a great book, and I would definitely recommend it to anybody. If I do any more videos like this, they'll be on my second channel, but I just kind of wanted to reach out to more of you guys. Let me know what you guys think, or if you have read it, your thoughts, your opinions. And like I said, I didn't go into depth too much about this, but because I don't want to give it away because it's such a good book. So I'll see you guys soon. Bye.